could have looked at tonight's matchup against the Dolphins one of two ways. That it's a tough opponent because historically Miami holds a 12-3 edge in the all-time series. They had won 9 straight. Or that the Bengals should have had no problems with one of the NFL's worst teams coming in as a 5.5-point favorite. Let's go down to Paul Brown Stadium for those highlights.
From the University of Southern California, number 9, Carson Palmer.
Great ovation for Carson Palmer, but the banged-up offensive line can't stop the Dolphins' rush, and the rookie quarterback goes down. 1 of 3 Miami first-half sacks. Lamont Brightfield on the punt return here has a hole and full speed ahead, but Kenny Watson with a big hit. That causes the fumble. The Bengals get the first turnover. Matt Schobel recovers. Great effort by Watson. Look at it again. Boom. Now that is using your head. The drive starts at the Miami 48. Palmer threads the needle to his favorite target, Chad Johnson. 16-yard pickup. That sets up Shane Graham's 38-yard field goal. But the primetime bright lights, oh, it must have gotten in Graham's eyes. He uncharacteristically pushes that ball wide right. Still no score. For Graham, just the third miss in 26 tries with the Bengals. Start the second quarter. A.J. Feely hits Chris Chambers, who rambles 19 yards down to the Bengals 25 before Terrell Roberts brings him down. And Alindo Mari, well, the Miami kicker doesn't miss. 43-yard field goal. That puts the first points on the board as the Dolphins are up 3-0. Rough first half for Carson Palmer. Under pressure from Antoine Edwards. Pass tipped up in the air. Jason Taylor comes up with the pick. The Bengals with only 100 total yards of offense in that first half. Fortunately, Feely wasn't feeling it either. His pass is into triple coverage. Batted by Torrey James, and eventually he ends up with it in the crowd. They head to the locker room, Miami leading by the score of 3-0. It takes 6 plays for the Bengals to take the lead in the second half. Feely stares down Chambers. Brian Simmons reads it all the way. Another interception. Simmons all the way, 50 yards, makes it 7-3. The defense feeds off the big play. Next series, Lamar Gordon stuffed in the backfield by Kevin Hardy and Kevin Casehorn. Miami just 30 total yards rushing. Wow, Bengals get great field position on the ensuing drive. It's TJ Hushmanzada, the end around, good for 11 yards, down to the Miami 23. Graham makes amends for his miss. This one, 48 yards, right down the middle with plenty of distance. No doubter, it's 10-3. Next Dolphin series, no chance against that pumped up defense. Justin Smith, wow, levels Feely for a 9-yard loss, another 3 and out. Ensuing series, 3rd and 4 for the Bengals. Palmer down the middle to Peter Warwick. 15-yard pickup gets him to the Miami 26. The drive stalls, but that's okay. It's Shane Graham on for 3 more. 36 yards, Marvin and the gang up 10, 13-3. Under 4.5 to go. Feely hits Randy McMichael over the middle. 29 yards to the Bengals 4. Next play, Feely under pressure goes over the middle. Dwayne Clemens misses the interception. It's deflected to the back of the end zone and caught by Chambers. It's 13-10, 53 yards in just 4 plays. Next series, Bengals go 3 and out. Kyle Larson, nice line drive punt to the wrong side of the field. 41 yards on the return. Lamont Brightfield, that is. Tons of room down the sidelines. And that sets up Alindo Mari from 47 yards. And it is right down the middle. We are tied at 13 apiece. Bengals last rally, 3rd and 6 from the 24. Carson the TJ on the sidelines. Tough catch. His only reception of the game. Palmer finishes 21-38, 147 yards. 4 plays. Carson 20 yards to Chad. CJ 3 catches. 45 yards, they get it down to the 26. 39-yard attempt to win the game with just 2 seconds remaining. Graham is perfect, 16-13. That is your final score as the Bengals win their first of the season. Let's go back out to Paul Brown Stadium where the voice of the Bengals, Brad Johansen, is standing by live. Brad?
And we are with a man of the hour, Shane Graham, who makes the game-winning field goal. And I suppose you always want redemption on something like that since you missed your first one of the year right out of the gate. How good was it to let it go? I know that always sounds like a stupid question, but how did it feel?
You know, it's a great feeling to be able to have that. Whether there was a miss or not earlier in the game, it's a great feeling to have. But, you know, it did take that taste out of your mouth. You know, it's a good thing I didn't have to go to bed tonight and have to think back on that other kick, you know. And now I can lay my head down and wake up in the morning. It's going to feel a lot better, you know.
One of the things that you said going into this, and it was obviously one of the topics after game one, Darren Simmons had said, Shane Graham needs to work on his kickoffs. You knew that. What did you do differently because it was more effective tonight?
Well, we put more time in it, and you know, during the week, and I even spent some time on my own with it when we weren't practicing, and you know, I knew that for us to get the coverage that we needed for field position, that I had to kick better, and you know, that's my job. That's what they pay us to do, and you know, the coverage guys last week did a good job of bailing me out. I gave them bad kicks; they kept them, you know, deep, and you know, I couldn't put that on their shoulders anymore. You know, I had to have better kicks, and, you know, I had better kicks this week, still not as good as I wanted, but, you know, you get what you can get, and you get ready for next week.
We talked about it many times, how there's kind of a three-part deal to kicking a field goal, the snap, the hold, and the kick. Obviously, Kyle Larson came in this year and had never held before. Kyle had a couple of high snaps that he got down for you tonight. How is he doing?
I'll tell you what, Kyle has done an amazing job for us, especially since the season started. You know, he kind of was raw in the preseason. He didn't look like a veteran, and now he looks like a veteran. He's punting the ball well. He's holding the ball well. He's for a guy who's never held, he's holding well, and for a guy who's held his whole life, he's still holding well. You know, he's just doing a great job, and you know, for practice games or whatever, you know, the guy's just, you know, he's a great guy and he works hard, and he wants nothing more but to do well for us.
Kickers, sometimes they say, can be a dime a dozen, but the Bengals didn't think that about you. Didn't want to let you go after you got an offer sheet out there. You get a multi-million dollar contract. You seem to come into this year saying, it will not change me. Has it changed you at all?
I'd like to say no. You know, you always have those few material things that you always said, you know, you'd love to have if you had money. And, you know, it's nice to have that, but when it comes down to it, you still play 60 minutes on Sunday, and, you know, the goalposts are still the same size. And, you know, it doesn't matter, you know, how much money anyone on this field makes. We're all equal when we're out here, and we all have to perform no matter what.
Home field advantage. I've talked to several guys already tonight. It seems like it's starting to turn around, that this is a place that you guys enjoy playing because it makes a difference with what the crowd is doing, and especially on national TV tonight.
The fans were great. You know, the jungle was definitely alive tonight. You know, from, you know, we do have a trend going that right now that we've, you know, we're winning home and losing away, but, you know, I think we need to fight to win, you know, every game we can. And, you know, but it's nice to have that feeling of warmth when we come in this stadium. We come out and, you know, see that the crowd's already in every seat, you know, before we even kick off. You know, it's just a nice feeling to look up and see, and, you know, not have to wait till halfway through the first quarter, you know, and even with the traffic around here, you know, today, it's just really nice to see that, and it was just a great electric atmosphere all day long.
Well, congratulations. Game-winning kick number one, a 39-yarder from Shane Graham. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
And the Bengals get their win. Harvey, we'll send it back to you.
All right, Brad, we'll look for you in just a little bit. Thank you very much. Hey, next week, Local 12 brings you the Ravens and Bengals live at 1 o'clock right here. And following the game, stay tuned to Local 12 for a post-game special, The Roar in 04. We'll have a game recap, live interviews, much like tonight. That's The Roar in 04 following next week's game, Bengals Nation right here. And we'll be back with more Bengals Nation post-game coverage right after this. Watching a very special edition of Bengals Nation post-game coverage as the Bengals have knocked off the Dolphins 16-13 at Paul Brown Stadium, and that's where we find the voice of the Bengals, Brad Johansen. Brad?
I am joined by Nate Webster, the middle linebacker who comes over, and Marvin Lewis had said it. First of all, congratulations, Nate, on win number one with the Bengals, but Marvin Lewis had said it as you coming over. I want this guy to be the leader on my defense. And, of course, after you lose game one, Nate Webster only shows up with two tackles and an assist on game one. The pressure
six.
Goes back on your shoulders. Coach's film says six. Is
yeah,
that what it is?
Yeah.
But you knew, you felt the pressure, people
yeah.
talking about it. Did you felt like the leadership role came to you tonight, and was it nice to be back in your house and show up?
Oh, yeah, man. It was good to be home tonight, bring the win. You know, last week, you know, it was real rough, but we got a hold of it, and we had a good week of practice, and took care of business today.
I talked to Kevin Hardy, who said that there just wasn't a whole lot, especially in the second half, that we didn't know what was coming. Why is that?
I got to say, it started from this week in practice, you know, watching them guys on film. It was a lot that they did, you know, that told, you know, what kind of runs or what kind of play action pass they was going to do. So it started in the film room and just transferred out here on the field.
Pressure was significant. Offense or a defensive line did a little bit more this week to make it easier for the linebacking corps.
The defense was snapping all night tonight. The guys up front made plays, sacks, kept the big boys off me, allowed the backers to roam and make tackles. You know, we got turnovers. What more can you ask from a defense?
Yeah, I want to talk about the chief criticism that's come on Nate Webster, not just here, but long before. Nate Webster's too small to be a middle linebacker. How would you like to respond to that, especially after this evening?
Oh, just let the dog out the cage, man. Just let the dog, just open the cage, let the dog out, and he go bite everything in the yard.
I like that. Did you feel the home field advantage tonight and looking forward to the Ravens coming in?
Oh, yeah, got to. You know, we're not going nowhere. We can't. We signed the contract, and whoever come, you know, we got to play them.
Fair enough.
We're not going nowhere.
Fair enough. Congratulations on win number one, Nate.
No stand tall through winter, summer, spring, and fall, baby.
I like it. Nate Webster, he's a poet, and I believe he already knows it. Harvey, I'll send it back to you.
Brad, isn't it interesting after a win how everybody's just happy and all smiles?
Funny how that works, isn't it?
We'll see you in just a little bit. Thank you very much. Okay. For more on the Bengals, log on to WKRC.com. Check out Bengals Nation, and while you're there, vote on the poll questions and post a line or two on the message board. Local 12 is your home for the best Bengals coverage. Against the Steelers in their eight-year existence, they are both 1-1. The Browns, who are trying to be 2-0 for the first time since 1993, are even as well. And the Bengals make it a four-way tie, everyone at 500. As we continue our Bengals post-game edition, now we're going to hear from the voice of the Bengals, Brad Johansen, who is live down at Paul Brown Stadium. Brad?
Harvey, thanks very much. Joined by Kevin Hardy of the linebacking corps. And as you said, it's always tough to get that first one, but how good does it feel now?
It feels real good. It feels real good. It was a national TV game. It was at home. And that's big because, we get the jungle rocking early in the year. We set the tone for the season, so it was just a huge win.
I ask you, what's the difference between New York and playing Miami? Why does the defense shine so well tonight, struggle so much in New York?
Well, there's a lot of things that go into that. Obviously, in the first game, an offense can come out and do things that you haven't seen on film because it's the first game of the year. We got a chance to study Miami's offense this week and the things that they did last week, and it'll give some good keys. And also, we were able to correct some of the things that we did the first week. And I think guys were just excited to come out and play, played hard, and as a result, we came up with a big win.
Second half, I'm saying it's almost as if they know what's going to happen. It seems as if every play they call, they're ready for it. Did you know what was coming, especially second half-wise?
Well, we knew tendencies and things that they got in different formations. We had an idea what was going on, and then whenever we got them in, obviously third and long, that's where you have them, backed up, you can come after them. So all week long, we looked at the tendencies, and they just came true tonight.
I asked Brian Simmons earlier. I said, does this give you more confidence as far as the defense? And he kind of smiled at me and said, we already had the confidence. You guys, that's taking that away from us. This defense just beginning to gel now?
Yeah, and we got to keep going. Obviously tonight we took a big step, but at the same time we know that their offense isn't the same offense that the Jets had last week, and they're not the same offense that we're going to see next week in Baltimore. So we take this, we look at the tape tomorrow, we just build from it because obviously it's still a long season ahead, and right now we're tied for first in the division.
How about
so
that?
Keep going.
Wait, you said it's home. Are you getting a home field advantage down Paul Brown Stadium?
I think so. I think, we picked up, from where we were last year, even though that last game last year against Cleveland wasn't so good, but we had a good home record last year. And this year our goal is to be undefeated at home and also, get some wins on the road. And if we do that, we'll be right along where we want to be, and that's in the playoffs.
Congratulations. Kevin Hardy, thanks very much. As the Bengals get a win, and 9 out of their last 10 games they've won here. For the Bengals, that means retooling the roster and rehashing the game plan. Marvin Lewis has waived center Thatcher Zelay. I can't even spit it out. He's on injured reserve. Has turned his attention now, Marvin has, to what needs improvement on his squad.
The defense gave up a couple explosive plays that needed to be eliminated just by doing our job mentally. We can't have mental lapses down the stretch. And same thing offensively. We had an opportunity to put the ball game away, and three drop passes in the last 4 minutes kept more time on the clock for them. And we had a chance to get out of that football game cleanly, and we kept it and we made it interesting.
Still no respect from the odds makers. The Bengals are 3-point underdogs Sunday. You can catch the game right here on Local 12, 1 o'clock. I will have the radio call on 1360 Homer and 92.5. The Fox. And stay tuned following the game for the Roar in 04, our Bengals Nation postgame special. I'll be live from Paul Brown Stadium with interviews and analysis. And once again, I'll be answering your email questions. So log on to WKRC.com and post those on Bengals Nation.